Welcome and good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. My name is Gemma Baldan. I'm Key Account Manager at Qualsys. To give you some background before we start, Qualsys is a vendor of governance, risk and compliance solutions via our flagship EQMS application. Our business was formed in 1995, so we're very well versed working with organisations of all shapes and sizes to optimise all manner of business processes. My role involves working with an array of businesses to provide support to ensure they achieve their objectives. I work closely with organisations such as Sodexo, BT and the University of Leeds to help them maximise their use of EQMS. Over the next 30 minutes, I'll provide an overview of EQMS Risk Manager. If you have any questions at all throughout the session, please ask by using the grey pane to your right. I will try and answer as many as I can at the end, but there are a lot of people on today's webinar, so if I'm unable to answer during the session, I'll endeavour to respond afterwards. Also, to let you know, the presentation and recording from the workshop will be available to view tomorrow. So let's begin. Here's today's agenda. We'll kick off by defining risk and then take a look at the typical challenges faced when managing risk. I'll then take you on a tour of our risk management software to demonstrate how you can use EQMS as your enterprise risk management system. During this, I'll show you some key features and explain how they could apply to your business. Finally, we'll summarise the benefits of EQMS Risk Manager and answer any questions you have at the end of the session. So, what is risk? Before we begin, we need to be mindful that ISO 31000, the global standard for managing risk, we're using their definition, is currently under revision and soon to be structured in the new Annex SL framework, while it will have a new wider leadership requirements. The standard defines risk as the effect of uncertainty on objectives. The key terms here are uncertainty and effect. Uncertainty is a state or condition that involves deficiency of information and leads to inadequate or incomplete knowledge or understanding. Externalising all business processes and sharing best practice and success, as well as all organisational deficiencies, really is key to ensuring business transparency and limiting uncertainty. The new requirement in ISO 9001:15 requires management teams to be mindful of internal and external threats that could prevent them from delivering the intended results. The second key here is that risks may result positively as well as negatively. It's important to be mindful of the opportunities which will help to facilitate the realisation of the intended results. Risk-based thinking is actually now an explicit requirement of ISO 9001:15. It requires organisations to apply a systematic approach to managing risk everywhere within the organisation. I've highlighted here how all the clauses now require organisations to manage risk throughout all processes. Clause 4, for example, requests processes are determined and the risks and opportunities highlighted against each process. Risk now really is woven into the fabric of the entire QMS. When Tony Haywood became CEO of BP in 2007, he vowed to make safety his top priority. Among the new rules were requirements that all employees use lids on coffee cups while walking and refrain from texting while driving. 3 years later, on Haywood's watch, the Deepwater Horizon oil rig exploded in the Gulf of Mexico, causing one of the worst man-made disasters in history. A US investigation commission attributed the disaster to management failures that crippled the ability of individuals involved to identify the risks they faced and to properly evaluate, communicate and address them. Haywood's story reflects a common problem. Despite all the rhetoric and money invested in it, risk management is too often treated as a compliance issue that can be solved by drawing up lots of rules and making sure all employees follow them. Many such rules, of course, are sensible and do reduce some risk that could severely damage a company, but rules-based risk management will not diminish either the likelihood or the impact of a disaster such as Deepwater Horizon. In Lehman Brothers, risk manager was demoted in status and brushed under the rug as the company ran itself into the ground, refusing to look at the truth behind massive profits being made from mortgage-backed securities, which played a large role in the worldwide recession in 2007-08. So risk management itself needs to be deeply embedded within an organisation. If there's a kink in the chain, it can have costly and sometimes dangerous implications. Here are the five most common challenges organisations face when managing risk. The first is identifying the risk. It's really critical to understand the qualitative distinctions among types of risks that your organisation faces. Once risks are identified, it's important to group them into similar categories. Three typical categories include preventable, strategy and external risk. Risk events from any category can be fatal to a company's strategy and even to its survival. Next is assess the risk. Here we apply the quantitative value to a risk and typically provide it with a RAG status to understand what action needs to be taken. Communicate risk. This is continuous and needs to happen at every stage within the risk lifecycle. In the new ISO 9001:15 standard, top-level management are explicitly required to promote risk-based thinking in respect to their organisation's QMS. Control. How can we maintain control of a risk? It's important to set criteria for the control. What actions required? How will actions be followed up? How often and by who? And finally, monitor. Risks are subject to change and require constant review. Different categories of risk may require different review periods. Understand what may affect each risk and then apply your review periods accordingly. These five challenges also translate into a typical risk lifecycle. EQMS provides a dynamic framework for managing and minimising organisational risk at each step in the life cycle, which is highlighted in orange here on the screen. So just before we begin our tour of the software, I'd like to ask you all, what are your main challenges when managing risk? I'll give you 60 seconds to answer via the grey pane to your right, and then I'll show you the results. Okay, so 78% of you agreed that identifying risk was a big challenge. And then we have a split between evaluating a risk and communicating a risk, which is quite a low proportion in compared to the initial 78%. So that proves that identifying the risk is key, but also very, very difficult initially until you can understand potentially how to measure those risks and what categories each risk fall into. Thank you for sharing, everyone. Okay, so I'm now going to take you through a tour of EQMS Risk Manager. We'll go through that now. So here we have our EQMS login screen. We can simply log in very easily via a web browser. EQMS can be also installed on-premise as well, if that's your preferred IT solution. Upon login, EQMS automatically takes users directly to their to-do list, detailing all actions they must complete within the system. As EQMS is permission-driven, each user can have a unique set of privileges and a unique to-do list. All associated risk management actions or your communication will live here. Before we document and assess an example risk, I'd like to take you to the EQMS dashboard. A critical part of successful risk management is the ability to monitor risk regularly. The KPI dashboard provides real-time data across all EQMS modules, including risk, and presents a bird's-eye view of business critical data. So I'm just going to take a look at this particular report here. So the great thing about all these individual reports, and there are hundreds of EQMS, is that they can all be tailored quite specifically depending on how you want to slice the data. So here I can select a particular risk category, I can select a particular risk owner, I can also select a particular area of the business or customer depending on how you've segmented your organisation. So it gives me a full definition of data. The data is also fully drilled down, so I can click onto an area, so I've clicked on all high risks here, and it's provided me with a list of these risks on two separate pages. And I can even drill down further to see the record itself. So transparency here is absolutely key. So it's provided all of the information. This is a risk record within EQMS, the name of the risk and a description, and also what the impact could be should this risk be realised. It's also calculated the class of risk. In this instance, it's high, and we'll come on to how that's calculated shortly. Okay, so there are a host of other reports and they sit within the Risk Manager module, including a risk heat map, which we can take a look at shortly. EQMS is made up of a set of integrated modules, including audit management, CAPA, document management, and of course risk, which I can now select here. Once we select Risk Manager, the system automatically takes us through to the risk database or the risk log, where all risks are recorded and stored, and here I can further slice and manipulate my data. So I've got a whole section of fields here. I can choose to slice risks by particular standard, by particular risk category, by the asset affecting the risk, or by the owner who actually is responsible for ensuring this risk is controlled. I can also segment by the level of risk, high, low or medium, status, whether it's submitted under assessment, assessed or approved, and I can also add additional search criteria if I want to. So we'll take a quick look at an example risk here. I click and it takes me directly through. Now remember, EQMS is permission driven, so if I have the permissions to see this risk or this module, then I can, and if I don't, this doesn't exist to me. So here, all the information is complete, along with my risk score or my RAG status, which in this instance is high. And that's because I've selected previously a likelihood and an impact. And those scores together have then provided me with my risk score. So let's have a go at documenting and assessing a new risk together. So it's very easy to do. I select new risk here and the system provides me with a blank template, and now I can start to populate. So I'm selecting, or I'm naming my risk, incorrect work instruction in operation. So this is a work instruction that should have been updated, hasn't been updated, and this is could cause a potential threat to my business. I'm obviously not filling this in fully because we're quite short for time today, but you can fill in the description of the risk, and the impact description is what you would expect to happen should this risk be realised. So at this point, I can now begin to select which assets will be affected with regards to this particular risk. So quite straightforward to select from. I can also select the category of risk. So in this instance, this is operational. And I'll select my assets. And we'll say financial because potentially I could be fined if the product is released and the recipe is incorrect or the way it's been built is also incorrect. So I've said financial. Now at this point, the system asks me to enter a likelihood and an impact, and I can select here. So I will say that this is possible, and from an impact perspective, it's not a health and safety impact, but that there is a potential financial impact here. So I will select financial impact. So as soon as I hit the save button, the system will now calculate the RAG status on my behalf. And it's calculated that as high, and that's all to do with a weighting which sits at the back of the system. So the first thing is identifying your risk, which we've done here, and documenting it, which we've done. I've now assessed the risk, which has been automatic. And now what we can do is continue to document that risk. So along the top of the page, you'll see a number of tabs. And the first one is journal. Here I can record a whole host of information with regards to this risk. I can store documents against it. So my next is standards. I can apply standards against particular risks. So if you know that a particular standard or regulation is at risk, it's very, very easy to apply a particular standard or regulation against an individually identified risk. So I'll just select a couple for now. We talked about particular areas of a business, or also particular, linking particular parts of EQMS. So EQMS is fully integrated, which means it talks to all elements. So there's a supplier module, an issue module, a module that records jobs, audits, a whole host of information. So I can actually associate a particular risk with an audit. So I can click on the plus button, it'll bring up a whole host of audits, and I can search for whichever one I want to link to this risk. I'll just choose the top one. So if I click onto this, you can actually see this takes me through to the complete audit record with all of the details and the audit questionnaire as well, which has all been completed. So I know that's the right one, and I can link that together quite neatly. So the system will tell me when that's been linked. There we go. And now we can see at the bottom of the screen, we have an audit linked to this risk, and that link will remain consistently within the system. So we've now documented our risk, and we need to apply some control. So from the perspective of applied control, we can select a number of controls which have already been defined within the system. So in this instance, there's a procedural control here, which is in regards to review periods of particular procedures. And it's an operational control, and we know now that every 70 days there needs to be an audit. We've obviously just selected an audit by associated items to ensure that this procedural control is in place. So this is your review that will happen now on a regular basis. So I can simply select my owner, who's going to be responsible, and then select my control. And that control is now linked into this particular risk. So if I come back to my risk and click save, all that information has now been stored. So our risk is fully documented, it's been assessed, it's been communicated via the control, it's been controlled, and the final element now of our risk lifecycle is to monitor and also review our risks. So So hopefully that's made sense to everybody there. So as I move down here and click on to reports, we've got a further host of reports here, and we obviously saw earlier on the EQMS dashboard, which details every single report, but there's some additional reports in each module. So a critical one here is the heat map. So the heat map again allows you to slice and manipulate data dependent on category, the asset affected, parts of the business, particular standards, and also date ranges. And if I scroll down, I can show the impact versus the likelihood on my 5x5 matrix here. So at the moment we're showing every single risk that's listed. Now obviously the risks that you haven't got to worry about too much, where the likelihood is very low and the impact's very low, the risks that you have got to start being concerned about is where you have a high likelihood and a high impact. So these two risks here are risks that I need to be very aware of. This risk here, green, is very, very low. The likelihood and the impact is very low. So this allows this prioritisation and it allows ongoing review. So that concludes our demonstration of EQMS Risk Manager, and we'll now go back into the presentation just to recap with the benefits. So EQMS Risk Manager allows you to assess risk using your own framework to identify, quantify and prioritise your risk. Every risk is explicit and is dealt with appropriately. You can apply time-sensitive controls, so you've always got that assessment and risks can't be forgotten. There's real-time availability of qualitative and quantitative data through the dashboard and also the individual reports. And EQMS integrates with all the other modules, so your risk system can talk to your CAPA system and your audit system. And the most important thing, it enforces responsibility and ensures that communication is thorough throughout the whole business. Okay, so we're just going to take a look at some questions that we've received. If you bear with us, we've got quite a few to get through. So the first one that I've received, how can I categorise organisational risk? So I would say the first step is to define each individual risk, describe the risk, and try to describe the impact of what the risk would, the impact of the risk if that was realised. Next, understand where in the business the risk sits. Risks can fall into a number of categories: operational, financial, health and safety, strategic, and many may be industry specific. Once you've categorised your risks, look for similarities across the categories. This will allow you to apply similar types of controls to similar risk. A health and safety risk, for example, may need a monthly walking audit to check premises. This type of control could be applied to a host of different health and safety risks. Okay, so I'll just cherry pick another one. What's the best way to prioritise risk? So prioritising is relatively easy as long as each risk is assessed individually, asking the questions quantitatively, how big is the impact and how real is the likelihood. You can apply weightings to your responses and that will help calculate your priorities. On your heat map within EQMS, all of this is automatic, so your priorities are really easy to spot. They're anything sitting at the bottom right of the grid, high likelihood, high impact. And all in all, it's anything that could have a catastrophic effect on the business. Okay, so final question, and quite a useful one. How is the risk score calculated in EQMS? So EQMS is an off-the-shelf software that allows wide-ranging configuration. This means you can tailor the system to your business requirements to ensure it's fit for purpose. and in line with your current processes. So within the demo system we saw today, when entering a new risk and creating a risk score, there were a number of potential likelihoods and impacts which I could select from. Each impact and each likelihood can be configured and weighted accordingly, depending on an organisation's requirements. The risk score or RAG status is calculated automatically by combining the weighted impact and likelihood selections. So if there's any other questions, you're welcome to ask those. And if not, we'll move on. So someone has asked which languages are available for Risk Manager. EQMS can operate in any language. It's a global solution, so lots of the organisations we work with use this literally across the globe. So there's no issue at all with language compatibility. Okay. So that brings us almost to the end of the session. Thank you all for your time today. I trust it's been an informative webinar. We're running a host of other webinars over the coming months. These include Health and Safety Management with EQMS, which is October, GRC and the Internet of Things, which is the 7th of September, so that's in a couple of weeks. One-to-one demonstrations are also available at any time, so if you know any of these are of interest, please let us know, and you can contact us on help@qualsys.co.uk. Before we close, there is a short survey at the end of this for you to feedback your thoughts. We would be really grateful if you could give us some feedback and let us know how we can improve. So thanks again. We hope you can join us at some of the upcoming events.